Good morning, children. Welcome to Get Easy Maths. I hope you all are doing well and also doing study well. So moving towards our lesson integer, the next part is another properties regarding division and subtraction. So please watch it carefully and try to understand it. Dear students, moving toward the next part of the integers, that is properties of subtraction of integers. First, I would like to clear what is closure property. As we know that for any two integers a and b, their subtraction, that is a minus b, is also an integer. For example, when you are going to subtract 2 from 3, the answer is 1, and 1 is again a positive integer. Like we have a and b, and then subtraction we can also write as like this: a minus b is equal to a plus in bracket minus of b. They both are same. Now just look at some examples, like 10 minus 8, that answer will be positive 2. Here in subtraction, when you are performing subtraction, always give the sign of a bigger integer value. Like in example number 2, here we have to subtract minus 2 from 10. Minus 2 from 10. So you can see here 10, and this minus of minus becomes plus. That is 10 plus 2. And what's 10 plus 2? We know that it's 12. So when you are opening bracket with outside minus sign, that minus minus become plus. Keep in mind. Then moving to the next example, you are having minus of 10. Minus in bracket minus 2 means you are going to subtract minus 2 from minus 10. Then it's so simple. You have to write down first integer as it is, that is minus 10, and then minus of minus, it become plus 2. And as you can see here, minus of 10 plus 2, here we are having one negative integer, one positive integer. So we are going to do subtraction. Yes, and subtraction is always, you have to do subtract the smaller number from the bigger number, that is 8. And always you have to give the sign of bigger number, that is your bigger number is 10. So 10 having the sign of minus, so give it the sign of minus. Then you are having a next fourth example, minus 10 minus 2. This one, when you are having both the minus, in this case you have to do just simply add them. Answer will come 12, and you have to keep the minus sign as it is. Keep in mind these all variety of examples. Moving to the next example, fifth one, we are having fifth example as subtracting 0 from minus 10. Subtracting 0 means subtracting nothing from minus 10, that means minus 10 will be as it is. Now moving to the sixth example, you have to subtract 10 from 0, means the sign will be of there of minus, and it will become minus 10 here. This one. Now moving to the next example, you have to subtract minus of 10 from 0, and you have seen that outside of the bracket there is a minus sign. So that minus and that minus becomes plus, and it becomes positive 10. Okay. Moving to the next, we are having commutative property. As in the previous video we have seen commutative property for addition, that was true there, but here the subtraction is not commutative for integers. I am repeating, subtraction is not commutative for integers. For any integers a and b, you can't write a minus b is equal to b minus a, which is totally wrong. लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू आर गोइंग टू सब्ट्रैक्ट 3 फ्रॉम 5, आंसर यू विल गेट पॉजिटिव 2. 3 फ्रॉम 5 you will get a positive 2, and when the reverse you are going to do it, it will become another answer that is totally different. Moving to the next, you are having associative property. For the associative property, again subtraction is not associative for integers. Like for any integers, like say 3 integers A, B and C, the grouping is very very important under the subtraction, and any grouping here will not be considered and will not give you the correct result. Like in addition, we used to do any kind of grouping and the answer was obviously same, but here in subtraction it is not going to give the same result. You cannot say here A minus of B, A in bracket B minus C, which is not going to give the same result as in one bracket A minus B minus FC. Your grouping is very very important, and that's why associative property is false under the subtraction for integers. Moving to the next, that is properties of division of integers. Again, division is one of the important arithmetic operation. First, we are having closure property. Let me clear you, integers are not closed under division. Like for example, this example you see 18 divided by 3 is equal to 6, and 6 is here integer. But when you are going to divide 3 by 18, the answer will be a fraction, which is not an integer. Moving to the next, commutative property. Division of integers is not commutative. As in the first example, A divided by B is never going to be equal to B divided by A. So here commutative property again get fails. Next, division of integers is not associative. Obviously, the grouping matters here also. When you are going to take any integers A, B and C and you are going to divide in any order, it may gives you another result which is not going to equal. Like here, you are not going to get the same result. That's why this A divided by B divided by C, which is not going to go equal for this one. LHS is not going to come equal to RHS, this side. And one important thing, property, that division or dividing any integer by 1 always give the integer itself. Let's general consider any integer A. When you are going to divide A by 1, always answer is going to integer itself. Like 4 by 1 is 4, minus 2 by 1 is minus 2. Last property is division by 0 is not defined. For any integer A, when you are going to divide it by 0, the answer is not defined, it is undefined.